I'm going to share with you a list of the shortest road trips that you can take from Johannesburg that will lead you to some of the most exciting places you may have heard about or you have never thought about. Thank you so much for all the returning subscribers. Again, we're celebrating 1,000. Thank you guys so much. And hi to everyone that's new. Hopefully I can guide you and inspire you to travel more and make travel a lifestyle. Also, do not forget to tune in to SABC 3 every Monday night at 9 p.m. to catch me on the longest date. Hashtag Team Somali. If you don't already know, your girl is part of the show and she is paired up with Marwandla. If you have not watched the show so far, bro, you're playing yourself. It's literally the most exciting reality show that's airing on national TV right now. Please check it out. We had so much fun and so much drama. I honestly just, oh my gosh, like I want you guys to see this.
Next time on The Longest Date.
Come
on this side.
One,
two.
Time balance.
Main on it.
Seen all these other girl. I hate this.
One of values. After finding out that you slept with Zinkler, now it's vulgar.
It smashed. It was nice. I enjoyed it.
Welcome to the couple swap.
The Longest Date. Mondays at 9 p.m. on SABC 3.
Please go follow me on all my socials so you can be up to absolute date. You get me. All right, so without further ado, let's jump into this list. Trust me. There's going to be some surprises in this list.
If you only believe me, don't you think like that? I will love you.
Where we were staying in our feed vlog, and I actually got tired of answering this question, so I thought, you know what, let me just make a road trip series of the most accessible places from Johannesburg, how long they take, what are the highlights of these places, and then week by week we'll talk about where we can stay in each of those places. So if you're down, definitely subscribe, definitely turn on the notifications, because without a doubt I will be dropping places to stay for each of these places so that you guys can plan your next trip as soon as possible. So this is going to be a road trips edition, so I'm going to tell you where to go, and then every week we're going to talk about what's exciting about that place and where to stay. Number one on the list, we all know, and if you haven't been to this place yet, again, this is your sign, okay? This is for you. Number one on the list is Johannesburg to Hafti. So this route is only an hour long, literally one of the shortest ways to literally change your scenery. You get to Hafti and it's a beautiful dam, so much accommodation, there's so many little things to do around, like the Lusedi Cultural Village, there is the Silver Orange Bistro, which only has come to my attention recently, and I really think it's a beautiful place. It's also known as Almost Orange, if you haven't seen people post about it, oh my goodness, just type Almost Orange on Instagram and you will see the most scenic posts, honestly. Well known for their Sunday lunches and their Sunday breakfast, so honestly it's worth going over the weekend. If you want to change your scenery and you're tired of going to the same old places in Joburg, take a 1 hour trip to Hafti's and have yourself a beautiful Sunday. Number two on this list is Val. From Johannesburg is literally also only an hour. You get there, there's a beautifully long river with a lot of accommodation side to side, a lot of restaurants, businesses. It's literally such a beautiful and scenic area. A beautiful place at the Val called Pont de Val. I think it's an estate because there's a hotel, there's restaurants, there's apartments, there's just so much. It's such a beautiful place. They host picnics, they host wine tastings. They host car shows, they host paint dates, they host concerts. It's such a beautiful place. So if you haven't been to the bar, or if you ran out of places to go to, this is definitely a place for you to check out, and it's only an hour away from Johannesburg. Also along the Vaal River, you can drive down to Barreys. It's only 20 minutes down from Port de Vaal. It's a lot cheaper to stay there, and there's little hiking trails, a nature reserve. It's a very scenic place, low budget. If you want to be in a different space as well, very suitable. And I mean, from Johannesburg, it's like an hour, 20 minutes drive. Number three on this list is Magali. Magaliesburg is underrated. There are so many exciting things to do there that I want to try. For example, hiking the Castle Gorge route looks stunning. There's like natural pools. There's just so many scenic things that I would like to see myself do. So Magaliesburg is only like an hour 20 minutes out of Johannesburg, full of nature, full of adventure. I found this amazing place called Wicked Food Earth. So what they do there, they host cooking classes for people, and they only literally cost 750 rand. You get to learn how to make exquisite meals, and I think that's just such a worthwhile experience. Wicked Food Farm is a restaurant and farm. They host cooking classes using the ingredients from their garden. I think that if you learn how to cook with fresh ingredients, like, you'll have a bigger appreciation for food and taste and aromas as a whole. Jam-packed with things to do. So don't sleep on this place. If you haven't been to Magaliesburg, put it on your bucket list. In fact, there is a long weekend coming up soon, so check if you can find any places to stay around there, and literally take a couple of friends, take your partner, take your brother, sister, mother, take somebody, take yourself, okay? Take yourself and go have an adventure. Last but not least, so this is a really quick video. I just really wanted to share these exciting places with you and share some highlights that I found that make these places really appealing to me and possibly you. But the last place that I have been wanting to visit for over a year now is called Cairns. Drive from Johannesburg, 3 hours, 3.5 hours, but I think that what you see there is so worth it. It's an amazing place, literally by the water of Lesotho, called the Golden Gate. I've been wanting to see that place for a while, and I'm like five to packing my bag and go like tomorrow, like now. Absolutely captivating, and I would love for you to experience it in as much as I want to experience it. So in the next couple of videos, I'll be hooking you up with places to stay for a group or for two people that are affordable, beautiful, accessible, based on all the different places that I've spoken about. So that'll be Vaal, Magaliesburg, Cairns, and Hatties. And I really hope that those will all be helpful when you plan your next holiday. Other than that, thanks for tuning in, guys. My name is Sunshine, and don't forget to follow me on all my socials. Love you.